Chapter 1 of The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn begins with a summary of the end of the adventures of Tom Sawyer. Tom Sawyer and Huckleberry Finn each received $6,000, and the money is put into a trust. They each receive $1 a day. Huck lives with the widow Douglas. Her goal is to civilize Huck. Huck is bored, and he leaves. Tom Sawyer finds him and convinces him he'll start a band of robbers, and Huck can join as long as he goes back to live with the widow and treat her with respect. The widow teaches Huck about religion, but when he learns Moses is dead, he loses interest. Heaven is boring, but the bad place sounds interesting. The widow won't let Huck smoke, but the widow herself takes snuff. Miss Watson, the widow's sister, teaches Huck how to read and write. Huck is bored and lonely with this situation, and he sneaks out of the house and goes to find Tom Sawyer. Chapter 1 starts off as a continuation of the adventures of Tom Sawyer. Huckleberry Finn is his own character, and his book stands on its own. Readers don't have to have read Tom Sawyer to understand the plot here. The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn focuses on boys and adventure. The book also serves as social commentary. Huck's voice and perspective are unsophisticated and conversational. Despite his way of seeing things, Huck is direct and observant. He recognizes truth and is not afraid to question his elders. He lacks education, but he recognizes and disapproves of hypocrites and hypocritical behavior. The widow Douglas and Miss Watson are presented as upright Christian women. They insist on evening prayers and call the slaves to join them. Huck does not question this because it was a common occurrence. He calls the slaves he comes into contact with the N-word. Yeah, he uses the actual racial epithet. This term comes up all throughout the text. It was accepted dialect at the time. Slavery was an accepted institution all throughout the South. One could be perceived as moral and be a slaveholder. The text explores the contrast between the rules of civilization and freedom. When Huck is in the house, he feels confined. The rules of civilization don't make sense to him, and they seem to serve no purpose. Huck longs to be free so he can live by his own rules.